Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, Thank you. Thank you. Let us pray to God. Master, with boldness and without condemnation, to dare call you the Heavenly God as Father, and to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, and the Father.
Thank you.
morning. How are all my friends doing this morning? Good. Are you ready for a great sermon? Yes, are you so excited to be in church? Well, this morning, not only do I have a good sermon, but I have good props. And you're going to receive Holy Communion. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. I want to start with a question that I get all the time. People ask me, Father Alexi, who is your boss? And I want to know what you think. Who do I work for? Who's my boss? Sylvia, what do you think? You? Yes. Let's see, on the left. So, yes, up here. God. That's the most common answer. Most of the time when people think that I work directly for God, it reminds me of some people who come and they say, you know what, I don't need to come to church because I have a good relationship with God. I go straight to God. And so I asked them this question. This is what we're going to talk about today. Why do we need the church? And what is the church? So I've told you this before, but I want to remind you. The church is not just a building. In fact, it's not a building at all. Look around you. You are the church. Because the Christian church is a group of people who are continuing to grow and learn and change and become better so that they can learn how to love God to the fullest. So, what's the name of our church? Can anyone remind me? Anthony. What is it, Anthony? Saint Nicholas, right? This is Saint Nicholas Cathedral. But are there other churches that have the same exact faith as we do? What's your Babu's church's name? Papi Mikali is at Holy Trinity in Camp Hill. And there's other Orthodox churches. Can anyone think of another Orthodox church? How about our other PK, whose papa was a priest? Christopher, where are you? Where's Christopher? Oh, where's your papa a priest? In Stroudsburg, Holy Cross in Stroudsburg. And did you know that within about a two-hour radius, we have six churches, and they are Annunciation in Easton, Holy Cross in Stroudsburg, Holy Trinity in Camp Hill, St. Matthew's in Blandon, which is towards Reading, St. Constantine and Helen in Reading, and Annunciation in Lancaster. And all of these churches work together. Now, today is the feast of St. Photios, and it's a very important feast day for our church in the area. Not St. Nicholas, and not all the other little churches, but for the bigger church. Because did you know that my boss is actually a Metropolitan? And then his boss is God. And technically, my boss is Father Nicholas. His boss is the Metropolitan, and his boss is God. And so all the work I do with you, this is not Father Alexi's church or Father Nicholas's church. This is Metropolitan Sava's church. Do you remember last year we got to see him on the video Skype? We got to do morning prayers with him? So in the early church, when churches were being formed, like this group of people would come together, there would be a bishop for every city. But when there's a ton of churches in a ton of cities, instead of having one bishop in every city, the bishops ordained priests to go and do the work for them. So we all report to one bishop. And the feast day of St. Photios, who is an incredible bishop and patriarch, is the patron saint of our metropolis. So today, in the western region, all the priests are gathered together. In the central region in Pittsburgh, all the priests are gathered together with Metropolitan Sava. And here in the eastern region, all the priests are gathered together. So I'd like to introduce them to you. Would you like to meet them? Okay. So I'd like to start with the youngest and the oldest. If Father Aaron Gilbert can come out with Father Nicholas Kosis, you might have to help him.
I'm wondering that.
So there's a couple different kinds of priests. There's assistant priests, that's what I am, and that's what Father Aaron is. There's proistamini, or head priests, that's what Father Nicholas Palace is. Hello, Father. And then there's retired priests, like Father Nicholas. Now, do you think when you retire from being a parish priest that you stop working? No.
So these are the first two of our priests. So I want to ask you, if you have any questions for them, we can ask them. Like, I think a good question would be, how old are you? Should we ask that question? Let's start with that one. Father Aaron, how old are you?
I'm 27.
27 years old.
Did you know that's how old I was when I came here to this parish? Father Aaron was just ordained this year. Father, what's your pronoun, Mason? 91 years old. Did you know that means that you could fit three of Aaron's lives within one of Father Moses' life? How beautiful is that? Okay, let's meet more priests. Father Theodore and Father Andrew, are you available? So here are two other priests. Now this is the next level of seniority. Father Andrew and Father Theodore both are the head priests of their parishes. Does anyone know who this priest looks like? This is actually my father. And this is another interesting thing about priests. You know, sometimes people think, oh, well, if you're not from a priest family, you can't be a priest, which is not true. However, there happen to be a lot of priest families here. Like, this is my father. His father was a priest. Father Andrew's brother-in-law is Father Nicholas. And there's so many relationships that happen within a metropolis, because when people love God, they marry people who love God. And it works very well. Now, let's see, is the deacon ready? So today's representative from St. Constantine and Helen in Reading is Deacon Constantine, and he is the son-in-law of our final priest. Oh, no, no, Papa Costa, you're going to have to come out too. Father Costa. Okay, good. So Father Costa isn't serving, but he's going to come out too. You know Father Costa. How many of you go to Father Costa's church? We have maybe one or two kids. Nina, Melina. You know Father Costa? Can you say hi, Father Costa? So Father Costa was a priest here for many years, actually. He was just like me. He was an assistant. And then finally, we have a deacon. Now, not finally, we're going to talk about Father Nicholas, but he seems busy. But the deacon has an important role. Did you notice what the deacon was doing? What's he doing? He was making all the noise. What was he saying? What was the deacon saying? He was leading us in worship. He was saying the petitions. So the prayers that you usually hear the priest say, like, again and again in priest, in peace, let us pray to the Lord. And then the people say, Lord have mercy. The deacon actually is the one that does that when you have a deacon. And then of course we have Father Nicholas. Father Nicholas, are you able to come out? Pate. So I want to tell you one very important thing. The church, the beauty of the church, is that it's not about who you know, it's about who you love. It's all about relationships. And so even though Metropolitan Savas is really our boss, it's really Father Nicholas and I who are your fathers here in this parish. You know why we call our priest fathers? They're the leaders of our church. Why don't we call them like the chief celebrating officer? Or the boss. Why don't we call them that? Why do we call our priests fathers? It's because we're a family, right? And Father Nicholas and I are here for your families and for you 24 hours a day if you need anything. We're your connection to the church, to the sacraments, to everyone else. So today, thank you very much, fathers, for gathering here at St. Nicholas in Bethlehem. And thank you for coming and worshiping with us. And remember, St. Photios and other of these saints that were patriarchs, they affected so many people. So you know me pretty well. Imagine being a patriarch and having thousands of churches underneath you. Imagine how important it is that you make the right decisions. How important it is that when you speak, people are inspired and turn towards God and love God. And St. Photios not only did that in a good way, he also fought against people that were fighting the church. And he defended the church. And he was even tortured. There was lots of things that happened to him that were difficult on him. So that gives us courage. Do you guys know what courage means? Okay, that's our strength. That's right. So we ask in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit that St. Photios give us the strength to greet the coming day in peace. right? Like we pray every morning. All right, why don't you stand up? What do we do every time we receive Holy Communion? Ask for forgiveness of our neighbor. So go ahead and hug your neighbor. Say, please forgive me.
Always now and forever into the ages of ages. Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever to the ages of ages.
Today is the patron saint of our diocese and of the synod of the church.